Now we will discuss about oxygen gas. Before we discuss about its preparation reaction, we try to understand why oxygen gas is colorless while it is paramagnetic by nature. In molecular orbital theory, given in chemical bonding and molecular structure, we have learned oxygen molecule has two unpaired electrons in anti-bonding p orbital. I have given this detail on the board. You can see oxygen atoms are given there. Their electronic configuration is also given there. Atomic orbitals having same energy will be overlapping with each other. You can see 1s2 overlapping with 1s2, 2s2 with 2s2 and 2p4 with 2p4. Come to the point. This is the overlapping of p orbitals. Okay. In the bottom we have bonding atomic orbitals. In the top we have anti-bonding atomic orbitals. In the bottom all the electrons are well paired. But in the top you can see in anti-bonding p orbitals, two unpaired electrons are there. From here it is very clear. Oxygen molecule is paramagnetic by nature. Why? Because it has unpaired electrons. But now question remains same. When it is paramagnetic by nature, why it is not colorful? Why it is colorless? So always keep in mind, molecular species having unpaired electrons during transition, if they emit radiation in the visible region, they will be colorful by nature. Okay, very important. Let me repeat this sentence again. Molecular species having unpaired electrons during the transition, if they emit radiation in the visible region. What is the visible region? We've given. Okay, if they emit radiation in the visible region, they will be colorful by nature. And if they do not emit radiation, despite the fact that they are having unpaired electrons, if they do not emit radiation in the visible region, they will not be colorful, they will be colorless. And this is what happens in case of oxygen molecule. Okay, oxygen molecule emit radiation in the ultraviolet region, not in the visible region. This is the region oxygen molecule, despite the fact having unpaired electrons, it is paramagnetic by nature. But since it emits radiation in the ultraviolet region, not in the visible region, it is colorless by nature. Let's move on to its preparation reaction. The first preparation reaction is by the thermal decomposition. Of chlorates, nitrates and permanganate. Now first we take metal chlorate. Most common metal chlorate is potassium chlorate. Chemical formula is KClO3. When it is heated at 150 degrees Celsius in the presence of a catalyst, we have manganese oxide. It decomposes into KCl, releasing oxygen gas. Okay, we can balance this equation. Equation is balanced. Now we move on to nitrates, metal nitrates. We have first group elements nitrates as well as second group elements nitrate. Okay, in the elements which are present in the first group, we have lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium. Now pay attention very carefully. When we heat the nitrate of lithium nitrate, see how the reaction is taking place. Lithium nitrate, keep in mind lithium shows anomalous properties with the rest of the elements in the group. Okay, that's why it shows different chemical reaction. Okay, when it is heated, so in this case it produces lithium oxide, nitrogen dioxide, releasing oxygen gas. Balance this equation, multiplied by 4, 2 and 4. Okay, 4, 3 is 12. 2 oxygen plus 2 oxygen, 4 oxygen, 4 oxygen, 4 to 8, 8 plus 4 is equal to 12 oxygen. Okay, oxygen balanced, equation is balanced. Now we talk about the nitrates of these metals. Okay, so in this case, metal nitrite and oxygen gas are produced. Okay, let's say we have potassium nitrate is there, potassium nitrate. Okay, on thermal decomposition, it produces KNO2, potassium nitrite and oxygen gas. Balance this equation. So keep in mind, you know, when thermal decomposition of lithium nitrate, this chemical reaction is different from the thermal decomposition of the rest of the metal nitrate. Okay, if I take sodium nitrate also, when it undergoes thermal decomposition, same chemical reaction. we have two molecules of sodium nitrite and oxygen gas. Let me take some more chemical reactions. Next, we have thermal decomposition of nitrates of second group elements, okay, such as magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, okay. Let's say I take a calcium nitrate, undergoes thermal decomposition, okay. The thermal decomposition of nitrates of second group elements is almost similar to the thermal decomposition of lithium nitrate. Lithium nitrate, calcium nitrate is there, and undergoing thermal decomposition produces calcium oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen gas, okay. Lithium nitrate, lithium oxide, nitrogen dioxide, oxygen gas, similar pattern is there, okay. Balance this equation, multiplied by 2, we have 2, how many nitrogen, 4 nitrogen multiplied by 4, okay. 3 to 6 to 12 oxygen, 2 plus 2 4 oxygen, 4 to 8 plus 4 equal to 12 oxygen, equation is balanced, okay. We can take the nitrate of some other element, such as let's say we have a lead nitrate, okay, we have lead nitrate. In a similar manner we can complete the reaction, okay. You can carry out the thermal decomposition, lead oxide, we have two molecules of lead oxide, 4NO2, and we have oxygen gas, okay. We have zinc nitrate, it also produces zinc oxide, nitrogen dioxide, oxygen gas, okay. Balance this equation, multiplied by 2, 4 oxygen gas is there. Now let's say we have a copper nitrate, okay, nitrate is there, thermal decomposition, okay, we get cupric oxide, metal oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen gas, okay. Very simple chemical reaction. Now in the last we have permanganate, and most common permanganate is what? Potassium permanganate, the strong oxidizing agent. KMnO4 undergoes thermal decomposition, this is potassium permanganate, and it converts into potassium magnate. Its chemical formula is K2MnO4. We get manganese oxide acting as a catalyst in the thermal decomposition of chlorate, metal chlorate, and then oxygen gas, okay. KMnO4 potassium permanganate and K2MnO4 is potassium magnate. Balance this equation, 2 potassium multiplied by 2. What about manganese? 1 manganese, second manganese. Manganese is also balanced. What about oxygen? 4 to 8 oxygen. 4 oxygen plus 2, 6 oxygen plus 2, 8 oxygen. Equation is balanced. Now let's move on to the second preparation reaction. The second preparation reaction is by the catalytic decomposition, means decomposition is taking place in the presence of a catalyst of hypochlorite. Let's say we have sodium hypochlorite, chemical formula is NaOCl, okay. In the presence of a catalyst it undergoes decomposition. You can see this is a nascent oxygen, it releases nascent oxygen very easily. You can take two molecules, then we get a 2NaCl and oxygen gas. It acts as a better oxidizing agent because easily it can release oxygen, okay. The third preparation reaction is by the electrolysis of water in the presence of traces of very small quantity, traces of strong acid or strong base, such as we have H2SO4 or strong base barium hydroxide, okay, a strong base is there. Water molecule undergoing electrolysis process. Cathode is negatively charged and anode is positively charged, okay. We have hydrogen carrying positive charge and oxygen carrying negative charge, okay. oxygen gas will be liberated at anode because it is positive, it is negative. And hydrogen gas will be liberated at cathode because cathode is negative, hydrogen is positive. Okay, simple. So we have a hydrogen gas released at cathode and oxygen gas is released at anode. Very simple chemical reaction. To accelerate the rate of reaction, we use the acids. Move on to the next preparation reaction. The fourth preparation reaction is by the thermal decomposition. Of metal oxide. When metal oxides are heated, they also release oxygen gas, such as silver oxide solid state. When it is heated, it converts into metal and releasing oxygen gas. Okay, balance this equation. 4 silver and oxygen is balanced. Next, we can take mercuric oxide, HgO, 2 molecules, thermal decomposition. Mercury is in the liquid state and oxygen gas. Okay, we can take lead tetraoxide, Pb3O4 is there, undergoes thermal decomposition, decomposes into PbO, releasing oxygen gas. Okay, make it even number. 2, 3, 6. Okay, 6 plus 2, 8 oxygen, 4, 2, 8 oxygen. If you take PbO2 also, it also undergoes thermal decomposition, converting into PbO, releasing oxygen gas. Okay, balance this equation, multiplied by 2, we have 2. 2 oxygen plus 2, 2, 2, 4, equation is balanced. Okay, now we can take manganese oxide also. MnO2, when it undergoes thermal decomposition, it also releases Mn3O4 is there. Okay, tetraoxide is there, and then we have oxygen gas. Balance this equation, 3 manganese multiplied by 3, 3 to 6, how many oxygen? 4 plus 2 is equal to 6 oxygen. Okay, so you can see by the thermal decomposition of metal oxide also, we can produce oxygen gas. Move on to the next preparation reaction. Fifth preparation reaction is by the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide undergoes catalytic decomposition in the presence of a catalyst, manganese oxide. Decomposes into liquid water, releasing oxygen gas. Balance this equation. Okay, the last preparation reaction is from air. Okay, we know air is a mixture of gases. In air we have oxygen gas, nitrogen gas also. Okay, the boiling point of nitrogen gas is 77.2 Kelvin and the boiling point of oxygen gas is 90 Kelvin. Okay, 90 Kelvin is there. Different in boiling point is there. That's why fractional distillation is used. The first of all, air is liquefied, and by using fractional distillation, since they are having different boiling point, these gases are segregated, they are separated. Okay, so these are the preparation reactions we have. Now move on to the physical properties. Next, we have physical properties of oxygen gas. Oxygen gas is a colorless and odorless gas. Oxygen gas is soluble in water. Keep in mind, oxygen gas is slightly soluble in water. Why? Because oxygen is non-polar by nature and water molecule is polar by nature. Okay, non-polar react with non-polar to produce polar molecule. Okay, non-polar, non-polar, polar molecule. Okay, we have the stable isotopes of oxygen. Oxygen 16, oxygen 17 and oxygen 18. And next, oxygen is paramagnetic by nature. Keep in mind, oxygen gas at 90 Kelvin liquefies, converts into liquid form, and its color is what? Pale blue. Okay, and further, if we increase the temperature at 55 Kelvin, it undergoes solidification, it solidifies. And that solid crystal will have bluish white colors. Now move on to the chemical reactions. Next we have chemical reaction of oxygen gas. Keep in mind oxygen gas is less reactive gas. Why? Because bond order is quite high, that is 2, and bond dissociation enthalpy is also quite high, that is 493.4 kilojoule per mole. Okay, since it is less reactive, that's why it reacts at high temperature, and once the reaction starts, it takes place on its own. Okay, keep in mind it supports combustion reaction. It supports, oxygen gas supports combustion reaction, but does not burn itself in the combustion reaction. Okay, and once the reaction is started, you know, it releases a lot of heat. That's why these reactions are exothermic by nature. And next we have oxygen gas is a colorless gas. That's why it does not show any change in its color when being present in blue or red litmus paper. Okay, move on to chemical reactions of oxygen gas with metals as well as non-metals. Oxygen gas reacts with almost all the metals, okay, except noble metals such as we have gold, platinum, etc. Okay, to form basic metal oxide. Metal oxides are basic in nature. Why? Because when they are added to water, they produce base. Okay, base. Let's say we have sodium reacting with oxygen gas. It forms sodium oxide, and in the sodium oxide, when we add water, we get sodium hydroxide. 2 hydrogen is there. So metal reacting with oxygen forming metal oxide, and when metal oxide is added to water, it produces a strong base. Okay, so these metal oxides are basic in nature. If I take a calcium reacting with oxygen gas, it forms calcium oxide. You can take 2 molecule, and when it is added to water, it produces calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide. Okay, next we have aluminium. It is also a metal reacting with oxygen. Aluminium oxide Al2O3 is there. Okay, multiplied by 2, even number we can make it, 4 is there, and we have 2 3 6 multiplied by 3. Okay, now we add water molecule. So this metal oxide will convert into base. We have aluminium hydroxide. Okay, 4 aluminium multiplied by 4. How many hydrogen? 4 3 is 12 multiplied by 6. Okay, equation is balanced. We take zinc sulfide also. When it reacts with oxygen, it produces zinc oxide and sulfur dioxide also. Sulfur dioxide. So this is metallic oxide, this is non-metallic oxide. Non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature, and metallic oxides are basic in nature. Okay, basic in nature. Multiplied by 2, you have zinc. Multiplied by 2, sulfur. Multiplied by 2. Okay, what about oxygen? 6 oxygen multiplied by 3. Okay, 6 oxygen. If we add water molecule to zinc oxide, it will produce zinc hydroxide. Okay, zinc hydroxide. Can take 2 molecules. I consider 1 molecule. Okay, 1 molecule. Otherwise, you multiply by 2, equation will be balanced. And if you take sulfur dioxide, add water molecule, you will get H2SO3. Acid is produced. Okay, you can balance the equation separately. You can write because it will be messed up. Okay. So when non-metallic oxides are added to water, they produce acid. That's why they are acidic in nature. And metallic oxide, when added to water, they produce base. That's why metallic oxides are basic in nature. Okay. Move on to some other reactions. Keep in mind, oxygen can react with metals to produce superoxide also, such as we have KO2. It is a complete addition reaction. KO2. In superoxide, oxygen is present in -half oxidation state. Okay, -half oxidation state. If you plug in over here, then you will get potassium present in +1 oxidation state. Okay, next reaction is with non-metals. You can see it is reacting with metals as well as non-metals. Okay, so non-metallic oxide will be formed which are acidic in nature. When added to water, they produce acid, such as we have sulfur. Reacting with oxygen producing sulfur dioxide when added to waters, we get H2SO3. If you take carbon, O2, then we have carbon dioxide added to waters, we get H2CO3, carbonic acid. Now let's say nitrogen is there and we get oxygen. This reaction we have learned already. This reaction takes place at very high temperature. About 2000 degrees Celsius, we get a nitric oxide. Okay, at very high temperature, this reaction takes place. Move on to some other chemical reactions. Next, we discuss about the oxidizing property of oxygen. Keep in mind, oxygen gas acts as an oxidizing agent. It oxidizes compounds under specific conditions. I have given some examples. You can see sulfur dioxide is undergoing oxidation in the presence of oxygen. And we have used one catalyst, V2O5, and converted into SO3. It is present in +4 oxidation state. In this case, sulfur is present in +6 oxidation state. Oxidation is taking place. Okay, under a specific condition. This reaction has been used for the special purpose only, for the formation of, for the production of sulfuric acid. The method is known as contact process. Okay. Next reaction is given there. HCl is undergoing oxidation under this condition. Okay, under this condition to produce chlorine gas. This method is used for the production of chlorine gas. A specific method is there. Okay. Last reaction is there. You can see combustion reaction is there. Methane is undergoing combustion reaction to produce carbon dioxide and water molecule.